In my previous video, I showed you how I built a completely ordinary garage for my robot lawnmower. You know, just a super basic garage with a 200 kilo concrete foundation, royal impregnated wood cladding, a window, steel roof, built-in LED strips, and of course a fully automated voice-controlled garage door powered by an Arduino, Google Assistant, ultrasonic sensor, and more than a few self-designed 3D printed parts.
So the garage has worked almost perfectly, but I have had some incidents. The GPS signal inside the garage is a bit too weak.
And this makes the mower somewhat unpredictable. Sometimes it doesn't go out. And then there's this thing.
So the whole internet situation here at the cabin is totally shit. So I'm gonna do something about that also.
And then
it's way too slow. So I will fix that. And also I will try to add some safety mechanism. So when it goes down, if it then crashes into Johan because he's standing around here, I want it to sense that and then go automatically up. And then there is this windows. So the glass is actually so thin that I can move my hand straight through it. So I will try to fix that also.
So first step, improving the satellite signal.
And in the Navimow app, I can of course see that it's a really bad GPS signal. And a bad GPS signal comes of course from the metal roof. I'm gonna do a test. Now I have a terrible signal. The only satellites that comes in is the ones that this little guy is picking up. I'm gonna try to open the roof and see if the signal gets any better. Yeah, that's way better. The blue ones is satellites that Johan is picking up directly, and the yellow ones is from the antenna on top of the roof. On this side of the house, I already have a window. I'm not totally sure, but I think that the satellites are mainly up there. I think I have a fix. I'm gonna add this. A roof window or skylight. 3 millimeter plastic glass. Polycarbonate, is it that? And it's sandwiched in between two layers. So this should actually be watertight. So let's mount it.
My hope, of course, is that by installing the skylight, the mower's GPS signal will be more stable, so it actually starts when it's supposed to, every time. I was asked a lot to upload a build guide for this project, with drawings, code, 3D prints and everything, so I had to make sure it's a solid setup. The build guide is available at Etsy now, link is below. And the window I made the same way as the little lid for the box in the last video. I designed the windows frame with a 3 millimeter gap, then I added a pause in the printing process at the specific layer so that I could insert the little glass and then start the print again.
Let's see from the inside. There it is. Yeah, looking good. All right, so let's check if the satellite signal is any better now. Nope. I think it just got a little bit worse. So the main problem is of course that it's a bad reception inside the garage. But when Johan is getting out, he will get clear sight up to the satellites. And then it's no problem at all. Come on. Now we can see that the light is green. No, blue.
So clearly, adding one skylight wasn't doing much. So the next weekend, I was back again. I made another window.
So now, after adding the two skylights, the signal quality is, I don't know, it's still poor, but it's good enough. So on to the next upgrade. I'm gonna change this quite slow linear actuator with this really fast one. I guess it's like 5 times as fast. And since this model is a lot faster, I think it will pull a lot more current from the electronics. So this is the edge bridge powering the actuator. And now it's set up in single mode. So I'm gonna do some rewiring and programming so that I can use both channels. That way it can handle a lot more current. And to fix the safety mechanism for the gate, I will have to add some additional electronics in the box. So
the new linear actuator is the same size as the last one. The travel length is 100 millimeters, but now it has a travel speed of 30 millimeters each second.
So I'm gonna try it with just one channel first, and after I'm gonna do a bridge setup. Hey Google, klipp gresset.
Hei du din svinpels. Ta opp dette. Johan skal ut og klippe gresset, så du slipper.
Hey Google, parker Johan.
Klart det. Johan allerede dukket.
Yeah, of course. Since the gate is a lot faster now, I can't resist. I'm gonna try to start the mower without opening the gate first, with the delay and everything. And this way see if the gate managed to open enough before the mower actually crashes into it. I don't think it will work, but start. Crash and... yeah, it sort of works. So this is actually a good thing, because normally I will use the Google Assistant and then have the delay for the gate to open fully before the machine is going out. But if Johan is now getting the good idea to start cutting by himself, I now know that Johan will not get stuck, or the gate. So that's a win. So now, since everything is working perfectly, I will disconnect everything and redo the whole thing.
And the reason for this is that I want to do some major upgrades, both at the code and also the electronics. So let's take it inside, at the living room.
I guess this will be on YouTube, so she will know. So this right here is basically the same display that I have already installed. But on this mold, it has this little chip on the backside. It's just a 4-pin connection. And by swapping them, I will get a lot cleaner look. I can remove all these real small wires and free up a lot of pins on the Arduino. But there is one problem. I didn't plan for this board, so it crashes. That needs to go. Yeah.
In my previous setup, I used the H-bridge 5-volt output to power the Arduino. But then I got some issues with the display. Sometimes it just made gibberish. I'm not entirely sure, but I think that was caused by voltage spikes from the motor, which of course is also powered by the H-bridge. And since I didn't have already made voltage regulator laying around at the cabin, I will have to make my own.
I have this one. It's called L7809CV, and it's a 9-volt regulator. And I will also add a fuse solder and a fuse condensators and also a diode. And at last, it's this little guy. So this is a, I don't know, current sensor. And I'm gonna use this one to help me make the safety function for the gate. So if the gate is crashing into something, I will assume that the current is peaking up. And then I can make the program to reverse the gate automatically. And I can do it both ways. If it crashes when it's going up, then it will go down. And if it crashes when it goes down, then it will go up. And I will fit everything on this board, or a part of this board.
When I was a kid, electronics was my big passion. While everyone else was off at soccer practice, I was in my room, or workshop, with my soldering iron. What a weirdo.
So let's see if the power supply works.
But now I'm 35 years old and even weirder.
13 volts, 9 volts. And that's a perfect voltage for powering the Arduino. But I didn't plan this little board when making this box. I'm gonna design a little bracket, glue it on here, and hopefully just click it on.
nice little piece.
I then mixed up some epoxy glue, stuck it on, and then started with the code. This code ended up getting pretty advanced. I'm by no means a professional coder, but ever since ChatGPT 5 came out, I'm suddenly insanely good at coding. Nothing has happened here. Then I reassembled the electronics. I was really excited to see everything working 100% on the very first test. But first I had to make the windows for the gate. I'm always a bit nervous when printing components like this. But hey, this is going good. But not for long.
Tell me a joke.
Something went wrong. Try again in a few seconds.
I think this came out quite good. I mean, the windows. The code on the other hand. That needed a lot of tweaking. The biggest challenge was creating the safety function. The gate has the reverse when it meets resistance, so this needed to be calibrated. And after a few hours in fine company of mosquitoes, it was finally ready. Even though this project is extremely overkill and maybe a solution to a problem that doesn't even exist, it's still been a real challenge. A mix of so many traits, and when it finally comes together, it gives a huge sense of achievement. Things don't always have to be serious or even necessary. I'm lucky to have the chance to do stuff like this. And if you're not in the same position, I still hope you enjoy watching someone else solve problems that don't really exist. Challenges are what makes me mentally stable. Or yeah, if you can even call it that by now.
Hey Google, creepy ass.
Now everything was working 100%, except of one thing, the Wi-Fi. The camera quality was terrible, and Johan's Wi-Fi connection, yeah, it was the same.
Only one of three dots. So when Johan is going out from here, all the way around here, and all the way up here, the Wi-Fi signal is almost lost. So the whole internet situation here at the cabin is totally shit. So I'm gonna do something about that also. So I got this. It's a 5G internet solution from Telenor, not sponsored, and it's a whole new mesh system from TP-Link, Wi-Fi 7B3600. So I'm gonna install that. So this is an external antenna, and I have already planned this. Let's try without tape. I had one.
I also designed and printed a little bracket for the switch.
Yeah, that's a perfect fit.
And for the Deco Wi-Fi router, I found them all online, so I didn't have to design that one myself. So I ended up installing four of these TP-Link Wi-Fi mesh routers. And finally, I got full coverage all across the property. If you're interested in seeing how I built this garage, check out my previous video. And if you like to build one yourself, I put together a do-it-yourself guide on Etsy with codes and 3D prints and everything. You will find the link below. And as always, feel free to leave me some comments and thumbs. I must say I really enjoy reading them and I do my best to reply to everyone. Have a great day.